As a geologist, I love making videos about large features seen on satellite or via Google Earth that make you ask, wait, how did this form? Examples include the platinum-rich Condor Massif in Russia, the Clearwater impact craters in Canada, and the Eye of the Sahara in Mauritania. As a result, I received a high number of requests to discuss a strange-looking large geologic feature which seemingly had zero information on it being located in an understudied part of the world, the nation of Madagascar. There, a 9.35-mile or 15.05-kilometer wide ring-like structure is present which looks like it contains a large depression in its center and yet is seemingly uplifted, with its center situated 210 meters or 689 feet above the surrounding landscape. Since scattered diamonds have been found in Madagascar in recent years, several locals wanted to know if this was a kimberlite pipe worth exploring. To understand where they are coming from, in Arizona, what is considered to be the world's largest kimberlite pipe is present at Buell Park, and while that does not contain any diamonds, you can see the resemblance between the two. However, this unnamed feature in Madagascar is far too large to be a kimberlite pipe, so I am sorry to say that no diamonds are present there. It also is not an impact crater due to the feature's irregular profile. So, with that ruled out, an igneous origin was essentially certain. By comparing to other known features, I was able to rule out the following possibilities. It was not a caldera due to there being evidence of uplift rather than subsidence, and it was not a tuff ring or a mar because its center was higher in elevation rather than deeper than its surroundings. After hours of investigations, I was able to determine the age of this feature, with its rock units forming sometime between 92 and 88 million years ago. Looking around, I even saw other similar-looking features which seemingly had the same ring dikes, some with multiple layers of such. Putting all of the pieces together, I determined that this massive feature was an unusually large example of what is termed a dome anticline, based in part due to its large degree of similarity with Mauritania's Eye of the Sahara. So, how did this feature form? Our story begins 155 million years ago when Madagascar broke away from the African plate. This created a series of rift valleys along western Madagascar which were subsequently filled in with sediment. For the next 63 million years, Madagascar drifted southwards while simultaneously being connected to the Indian tectonic plate until it reached the present-day location of Marion Island, 2,000 miles to the south. All of a sudden, the mushroom-shaped top of an unusually hot section of the mantle started to rise until it became centered underneath ancient eastern Madagascar. Reaching the crust, the head of this mantle plume sent incredibly large volumes of molten rock upwards via a pre-existing weak spot created more than 60 million years prior, the Western Rift Valley. Large outpourings of molten rock followed, where 100-kilometer-long fissures erupted at a rate of tens of thousands of cubic meters per second. These individual eruptions lasted for decades, quickly flooding large swaths of terrain in hundreds or even thousands of meters thick of basalt. However, not every large intrusion reached the surface, as some ceased their upward migration at depth, with this occurring to some at very shallow depths. These failed intrusions instead spread out between layers of sedimentary rock, forming what is known as a laccolith and causing the rock above them to dome upwards. In the case of our ancient feature, this involved a body of magma that contained approximately 46 cubic kilometers of molten rock. Due to the doming of above rock, fairly circular cracks developed, which portions of this magma then intruded into, forming ring dikes. In the 88 plus million years since, the softer overlying sedimentary rock eroded away while the harder igneous rock, including the ring dike, remained, creating this modern geologic oddity.